My Howard experience has been great since the beginning to the end. This is my last semester, and every part of it has been wonderful.
I love this. Like, Howard's been my dream. Like, it's pretty much everything that I've ever dreamed of, really.
So far, it's been very eventful. It hasn't been a boring time.
I'm pretty sure I've never experienced like anything that I've experienced here at Howard.
Like the homecoming events, I really enjoyed those, and it's been really fun.
So I've been dreaming of this for years. Like, since I was like 5. So I love this. Like, it's everything I ever expected.
And I'm pretty sure of it because like I've spoken to a lot of alumni, a lot of different alumni from other colleges and universities. And none of their stories or anything compares to any of the alumni that I spoke to. So I've enjoyed it greatly, and it's not going to be anything like it in the world.
I would tell them about the legacy and history behind it.
Honestly, when you come here, be prepared. It's just like anywhere else. It's a lot of whack individuals. It's a lot of pitfalls, it's a lot of women, so just stay focused, make sure you have your goals in mind, and go after them.
I gotta think about that.
Advice I would give them is that they should definitely visit DC before coming.
I know who you are amongst the masses, and guide yourself from yourself then and not from what the masses acceptable or is the standard. You shouldn't come to Howard looking to find yourself amongst other people, but you should find yourself amongst yourself among other people. That makes sense. Like, meaning, find yourself by knowing yourself and staying you among other people.
I learned a lot. The number one thing is that you can do anything that you want to do. If you want to do it, then do it.
Don't quit. Things are going to get hard. Like, life is going to get hard.
I learned that I'm more lazy than I thought I was.
There's no barriers as to what you want to do in life and how far you want to go.
You're going to question, like, how am I going to get through this?
But I can't make it a competition.
You can get through this. God gave you all the tools to get through this. Like, you have everything you need to get through whatever you're going through. Don't quit.
Sky's not the limit. Space is.
I learned so much just by going out of state, period. So from being independent to blossoming into, you know, the lady that I eventually want to become.
Being at Howard has really helped me get to know myself a lot better.
Howard has taught me so many things, from joining clubs, organizations, to the different classes that I've chosen.
It's really changed me. It's made me more self-sufficient.
You know, not only classes were able to educate me, but my experiences as well.
It's definitely let me know that there is a lot more that I can do than I had previously thought. It's let me know that I don't have limits on my potential and anything is possible.
The biggest thing that I love about Howard is definitely the beautiful women that they have here.
The yard. It's pretty.
Honestly, the women.
Howard has so many opportunities for like networking and so much. Like, I've met so many people since I've been at Howard.
And I've never met a huge mass of intellectual and beautiful females in one spot.
That's why I came. That's why I'm still here.
It's kind of hard for me to actually articulate that and put it into words, but the answer probably lies somewhere in between. The wires hanging off the ceiling and the holes in the wall. Basic ass.
On a scale of 1 through 10, if we're talking like the politics side of it, I would give it an 8. The only downfall is just like administration.
About like an 8, because like administration building, retarded.
I would give it a 7.
Like, my advisor, she don't want to deal with us at all. Like, we're supposed to be getting our pens for our schedules and all that. and she's like been taking off, like she could do that, like come on, like you're being paid for something, you feel me?
It's not as organized as people would like it to be.
My match is just cool.
But overall, we'll give it a 10.
But all around, I was good.
Because the family-oriented environment is really good for a lot of students on campus.
Because even if there were, you know, bad stuff that happened throughout my collegiate career at Howard, you know, I know it was still just like a lesson learned.
I love it. And I love being around so many educated black people. There's no other experience like this.
Shouldn't happen.
My number one thing with the problems that Howard students have with relationships is that they worry too much about what other people say.
It's easier for relationships to be, I guess, overwhelmed by the other peers in their class as far as gossiping and things like that.
Relationships at Howard is too caught up in what he says, she says, what he thinks, and what she thinks.
Relationships at Howard are very interesting.
The ratio's fucked up. Every girl wants the same nigga, so.
Personally, I'm a freshman. I feel I'm too young. I feel I need to test the waters.
Lots of distractions. Lots of women everywhere.
You too young, blah, blah. It's college. You shouldn't be really in a relationship, blah, blah, this and that.
But if you want to be in a relationship, be in a relationship. If you want to be single, being single. If you know you can't commit to any person, like, be single.
The truth of the matter is, like, you do what you want to do. I mean, that's your life.